I had this friend in school who would have access to all kind of forbidden, materials. I would read them with a lot of Hi. So I had this friend in school who would have access to all kind of forbidden, materials, and he would bring the small kind of mini comics or chapbooks about which were mostly pornography, heterosexual porn, to school. And he would get this from, railway stations or some pavements and stuff like that. And what we would do as friends is we would sit, and there'll be, four or five people around it, and we'll read them out aloud. And usually the task of reading was shouldered upon me because I would read them with lots of expression, articulation, and all of that. So that was in many ways my first encounters with sex, and mostly this would be heterosexual forms. So the woman is having sex mostly when the husband is not at home. And by default, one of the lessons that I inherited from those was that sex happens in the afternoon, because that's the time when the husband is not at the house, and this woman, mostly like Savita Bhabhi kind of a figure, would have these sexual escapades with different people. And I still remember the two things that I would oftentimes do is that those materials would have the moaning sounds with pauses in them. So when I would read them out, I would read them with a lot of like this. And that heaves and the shy was something I would realize that it's really comic because people around me would really enjoy that. So that's one of the things that I would do while reading them out. And one of the lessons that I inherited from these cheap pavement pornographic materials is that sex happens in the afternoon. And in many ways, this lesson has kind of remained with me, because I now, when I think about it, I think afternoon is the time when I love having sex, and somehow there's something about that moment which contributes to creating the feeling of the erotic around me. So that's one of the very first kind of sexual lessons or gyan that I got from those chapbooks. But the most hilarious part about those chapbooks is that they were mostly talking about heterosexual encounters. And now, when because I identify as a queer person, and now when I have my sexual encounters, I realize that how the timing is, it seems like a little odd fitting, because oftentimes you're out for work and stuff like that. So it seems like more of a fantasy rather than a lived experience.
So when I was in school, I was a very shy guy, and that's why I did not have many friends, and no one told me about sex. But then I was put in such a situation where I stumbled upon sex. So what happened was that in my colony, there was a friend from my school, and he called me once that, "Please come to my home. I have a new game, Tekken, those cassette game." So what happened when I went there? He shut the door, and then what happened? On his laptop, he showed me HD porn. And those were actually intense, hardcore scenes, and in and out, and I was traumatized. So my first idea about porn was that it is about sex, was it is just in and out. And then I realized, no. Yeah, what he showed me was unreal as fuck.
So when I was in school, I was given this sex gyan by this really cute guy in my class. I was crushing on him. And but I never had the courage to go up to him and talk to him. But then we would wave hi to each other in the corridor, and then we kind of became acquaintances. And then this one day, out of the blue, he asked me if I wanted to go out for drinks, and I thought that perhaps he also had a crush on me. And then I was really excited and got all dressed up, and we both went to a place to have some drinks. And obviously we got fake IDs made, and when we were there, he said that he wanted to tell me something. Now we are both sitting at the table, and I'm smiling from ear to ear, because I thought that perhaps he also noticed me as much as I noticed him in the corridors. And I was thinking that the thing that he wanted to tell me was that he also had a crush on me. But finally, the thing he told me was that he's bisexual and that he has a boyfriend. So I was like, this is so bad that he has a boyfriend, but this is also so good because he told me that he's bisexual. So the first person that I can come out to as a queer person. So I told him that I'm gay. And after that, we chatted up about it. He told me all his sexual encounters in school. And it was a really fun night. And this one advice which he gave me, which I think is a very good advice, is that you should never wait for a special occasion to put on a cute underwear. And the maximum amount of money you should spend on your, out of like, the money you spend on your clothes, the maximum amount should go on spending it on your underwear. And because you never know when an innocent encounter could turn into something more than that. So it's better to always be prepared than be embarrassed when your pants come down.